Let's admit it, we all want to have a fluent conversation with one foreign friend without stuttering here and there. So, we decide to practice speaking and, of course, learn from teachers and others as much as we can. However, teaching speaking skills to learners is not always a simple listen and repeat. Today, we will be getting to know about the four subcategories of teaching speaking, the teacher's role during each speaking session, and some other principles if you want to dip your toes in teaching speaking. So, what is teaching speaking skills actually about? Teaching speaking in general deals with four aspects, with the first one being teaching conversation. We can easily start and maintain a conversation in our native language, but maybe not so in other languages, which is why teaching conversation is necessary. As we all know, conversation happens all the time, not only in class, but also in everyday situations. So, the goal for teaching how to speak with other people is rather diverse. By having a successful conversation, students will gain confidence to learn more complicated characteristics of speaking skills in the future. And when the students are ready to communicate, the teacher will focus on the manner and accuracy of word production. In other words, they emphasize students' pronunciation through teaching pronunciation. Depending on the student's level, different teaching methods can be used for two main groups, beginners and advanced. Beginner students should learn to overcome their fear of making mistakes. Many students are embarrassed by their pronunciation, and experts believe this issue has a significant impact on students' ability to speak confidently. To help students get out of their comfort zone, the teacher should tell them that everyone makes mistakes, but the important thing is to learn from that to achieve their goals. As for advanced students, the teacher should help them improve their skills and teach them how to speak as natively as possible. Students at this level are expected to practice more on intonation, voice quality, phonetic distinctions between registers, and other refinements that can greatly improve their communication. Moving on to another level, we have teaching spoken English grammar. In a nutshell, this kind of grammar doesn't follow traditional rules, which make it extremely flexible and less strict than written grammar. Unlike its written counterpart, spoken grammar is a little bit tricky to explain to students. Therefore, two teaching solutions to resolve this problem have been proposed. In the first solution, students will listen to a conversation between competent speakers. After that, they will have some time to study transcripts and pick out grammar structures that are unfamiliar with what they have learned, or, in fact, teachers can teach spoken grammar through movies or daily conversations such as buying time language. However, some people believe that the teacher should concentrate on the core language that course-book dialogues tend to emphasize, and it is the only way to learn this unique grammar. Listenership is the final characteristic of teaching speaking skills. Being a good listener is as important as being an impressive speaker in conversations. To be one, students must know how to respond appropriately during the conversation. If needed, maintain eye contact and use supportive phrases such as "okay," "I see," and "all right" to keep the conversation going. They also need to know when to take or withhold turns talking, how to deal with interruptions and comments, etc. It is no doubt that teacher plays a key role in a classroom by assisting students with multiple speaking skills. To keep things under control, a good teacher should consider the following factors, including 1. Accuracy and fluency, which is one of the most basic requirements in speaking that every student must follow. 2. Complexity. The teacher needs to evaluate students' level based on their performance and adjust suitable lessons for them. 3. What makes speaking difficult? He or she also needs to learn the difficulties that students encounter during class. 4. Motivation. The teacher will be the one who encourages students to work and think critically. And finally, 5, materials, technology, and teacher education programs. Teaching speaking skills allows students to interact with the chat, so here are some fun and engaging speaking activities that a teacher could use. We have the classic discussion activity involving pair works or small groups, communication games allowing students to communicate and practice speaking fluently, acting from script, simulation and role play, which will let students to act out a scene from a movie or even a real life situation like a business meeting, interview or conversation in a hotel or cafe. Prepared talks and storytelling sessions, and finally, questionnaire, which is a useful tool to start a conversation. Last but not least, while teaching speaking skills, we should also take these essential principles into consideration. Balance between fluency and accuracy activities. There are many ways in which we can fall into the trap of offering content-based interactive exercises that don't take advantage of grammatical pointers or pronunciation recommendations in our present enthusiasm for interactive language instruction. So, as a teacher, if we want to keep ourselves out of this trap, when using any kind of teaching technique to build up students' fluency, remember to take this as a chance to assist students comprehend and apply the building block. Number 2, check the complexity of your technique. To bring out the perfect lecture, the teacher needs to make sure his or her techniques are appropriate and not too complicated to understand. In other words, the teacher will modify the technique's complexity to match the student's level. Number 3, provide techniques that spark students' interest. To improve student engagement in class activities, teachers should also provide techniques that can spark student interest. In another way to say, teachers should try to engage students with topics that are relevant to their daily lives, cultural customs, and so on. Number 4, encourage the use of authentic language in meaningful contexts. Authentic language is simply the communication of real messages as opposed to artificial practices and drills. For example, instead of using a traditional material, you could make use of real-life-based sources such as journal, articles, blog posts, and novels. Number 5, provide appropriate feedback. When learning a foreign language, students obviously rely on their teacher for the most effective linguistic source of feedback. The teacher's recommendations really mean a lot as a way to improve their speaking skills during class sessions. Principle number 6, capitalize on the natural link between speaking and listening. There are a number of communication methods that require both speaking and listening. Thus, teachers should place an emphasis on the natural link between speaking and listening skills during class time. Number 7, provide opportunities for students to engage in spoken communication. Most of the time, students have been trained to only speak when spoken. To get rid of that situation, when designing a speaking teaching techniques, teachers should consider giving students more opportunity to initiate language. And the final principle, encourage the creation of speaking strategies. Typically, students are fully aware of the concept of strategic competencies, but at the same time, they simply have no intention to establish their own strategies for achieving spoken communicating goals. So, the teacher should guide them through useful tactics and show them how to put these tactics into practice.